5x minus x equals to 5. 2 bracket 2x minus 3 equals to 4x minus 3. Hi everybody, I'm Liang, Mathematics here. I'm going to talk about this mathematics since Form 1 to Form 3 on this particular part called algebraic. Okay, algebraic. So I'm doing sort of like a generalized topics, okay, from Form 1 to Form 3 when it comes to unknown related stuff. Okay, what are the things that we have to... Now, so algebraic Form 1 to Form 3, how they evolve. Okay, so what are the words that you have? Okay, so number one, we'll talk about this word, okay, called term. And after that, we're going to talk about this word called expression. And then finally, come into this word called equation. Okay, and of course, our main focus here is to talk about these two. Okay, so we separate, like, understand like these three particular words here first. Okay, number one, if I get you a 4a, okay, 4a, this thing, we name it as an algebraic term. Okay, if I come into this thing called 4a plus 3, or maybe come into 4a plus 3b, for example. So what are these? Can you see there's two terms over here? Okay, you see two terms, or maybe if let's say you want to add another plus c, for example, so you get three terms. Okay, so if let's say a particular thing, or we suppose the correct word will be expression. Okay, so if let's say you have more than one term, we name it as one expression. So that's called the expression word lah. Okay, so there is one expression here. So how many terms you have here? Two terms. You have three terms here. Now, so when you come into the other one called we have this thing called equation. Okay, what's so special about this equation word? It's when you have 4a plus 3 equals to 5. So when you come into equation, right, as you separate, okay, when you compare to expression and equation, so what's so special about them? Of course, it's not about spelling, okay? It's about expression means you can basically simplify them only. Okay, when you come into equation, it means there's a possibility where you can solve the A answer. Okay, so that's the difference between expression and equation. You see, expression, there is no equals to something. Equation, there is equals to something. So that's the difference. Okay, so put this aside. Okay, so the evolved thing is about what? Okay, the evolved thing is about... Okay, now, we talk about Form 1. We learn those very, very basic stuff. Okay, let's say we talk about one very easy times related and adding some plus minus info inside. Okay, let's say we talk about Form 1. We learn something that easy. Let's say 3 times 2. Okay, so you get a 6. Right now, so we are dealing with something where we already memorized earlier back to like primary, right? So when you come into the next stage, you come into something like 3 bracket 2. So what's so special about 3 bracket 2? Bracket means times, right? You come into 6 again. Nothing special. That's why I say it's like slowly we evolve. Then when you come into the next stage, okay, something harder. So you have something like minus 3 times 2. So what's so special about it? Minus 3 times 2. So now it includes something called, you have to deal with the what? You deal with the symbol. Okay, where symbol means you have to decide your plus and minus, whether it becomes a positive answer or negative answer. So in this case, it's a positive answer and a positive question, and then it's a negative. Negative and a positive. Eventually, it comes out negative answer. 3 times 2, you get a 6. So you notice that there is two steps now. So the first one, you deal with the symbol, right? And the next one, you deal with the number. Okay, now, then when you slowly move further, you get something like minus 3, then bracket 2. It's the same thing, right? It's just that times now that it becomes bracket. So you see, again, we are doing the same thing. You see, minus and a plus. Or maybe you can say negative and positive. So you get a negative. And after that, 3 times 2, again, you get 6. So same thing. You are applying two steps. Okay, then, eventually when you come into, it's still under Form 1. Now it becomes like algebraic. Okay, algebraic includes inside already, right? So we have something like, okay, let's say, okay, we are doing something like minus 3a. And after that, suddenly we get a times 2 here, like, okay? Now, so there is a very important thing that you have to know. When you come into times defined, algebraic expression related question, the first thing you must understand is this Nike symbol. Okay, can you tell me what's the slogan of Nike? just do it. So whatever times divide related question, right? Just do it. Do everything. Stick them together. Okay, so there is how many steps here that involve? Involve in this particular question here. Okay, now, number one, we have to deal with the symbol again. Okay, which is your plus and minus. Okay, so there's a minus here. There's a plus here. You get a minus, right? Okay, so 3 times 2. Second steps. Okay, you're dealing with the number. And you get a 6. Okay, and after that, unknown. We don't care about whether it's the same unknown or different unknown. Just do it. So, just add an 8. So that's your answer. Okay, so that would be like the first stage of like unknown related times divide. Okay, now, we move further down. Okay, like let's say minus 3a. Then times with a 2ab, for example. Same unknown or different unknown? Obviously different unknown. Don't care. Do it. So when you do it, okay. Nah, but there's one thing that I missed out. Okay, of course, finally, I thought about that unknown thing, right? Just add everything in now, okay? Just include everything inside. Now, so now in this case, okay, same thing, we are doing the symbol first. Okay, symbol, minus, plus, you get a minus. Basically, I can say this conclusion now. When you get a different symbol like negative and plus, okay, negative, positive, okay? So you get a negative answer. 3 times 2, you get a 6. Now, after that, when you come into this thing, you have to be careful. Okay, can you tell me how many A's are there? 1A, so total there is 2, right? So we label as A squared. So how many B's here? B. So you see, it slowly becomes harder. Okay, now I further up to another range. Okay, let's say now. Okay, I get something like minus 3A squared B power 5 times with, okay, I've opened the bracket, minus 2, A3, then B power 4, for example. Okay, now it includes a lot of things. But there's one thing that I just want to emphasize a bit now. Okay, so some extra ideas. Okay, now, so the ideas I put it over here. Okay, so next, let's say I talk about something like A times A. Okay, so what is your answer over here? So some mistake that student did, they do something like A times A equals to 2A. No, that's a big wrong. Okay, so how we understand it? Very simple. Okay, let's say I talk about something like 3 times 3. I know the answer is 9, okay? But if let's say I write it in a square format, right? You'll write it as 3 square, right? So imagine if let's say your 3 becomes an A. Your 3 becomes an A. It becomes an A square. You understand? So when you come into like A square times A. So this thing is actually A times A, right? So you get A cubed. Okay, so that's the meaning. Very easy. So come into this case. So number one, deal with the symbol first. Negative, negative, or you can say minus, minus, same thing. So you get a plus. Okay, so plus, we can ignore. Okay, then 3 times 2, you get 6. A square means A times A. A cube means A times A times A. So how many A's are there? A total of 5. And then B5, B4, a total of 9. So you see, sort of like a very step-by-step baby step kind of explanation since form 1 up to like higher level a bit, but actually like let's say you come to KSSM, right? It's the same level. Okay, now then you further down into something where they include something called plus and minus. Okay, when they include something called plus and minus, okay, then you have to be extra careful. Extra careful. I have to repeat this word, extra careful. Okay, so when students come into this kind of like times divide question, okay, they sort of like, hey, something easy, okay, I can deal it myself. But when you come into plus minus, when you include it inside, right, you have to be extra careful. Okay, now first, I have to tell students, okay, number one, so when you do it plus minus, right, okay, you have to look at this word, okay, when your unknowns, okay, it shows the same unknown, please continue with your plus minus. When your unknown are different, okay, what you do? Stop. Okay, stop, man. Stop. Stop. Don't do it, okay? Because that will be your answer already. Okay, so when you come into your case where I slowly include more things inside. Okay, so let's talk about something like this again. Okay, so I'm doing the same example over here. Let's say minus 3 times 2a lah. Okay, so quite obvious that if let's say I repeat the same steps, right, you'll be telling me something like minus and plus, you get a minus, 3 times 2, you get a 6, then A, you put it back, is the 3 exact steps. This is the baby steps. You can do it faster, of course, that would be better. Okay, now then I further move down, right? Okay, let's say that this thing, I evolve into something like this. Okay, I evolve into something where I include plus minus inside already. So minus 3, open the bracket. Okay, now instead of writing 2a, I write 2a plus 3. Okay, so what it means. So now you have to deal with the normal board mass that you have to know. Okay, what is board mass? Board mass means, first thing, you have to deal with the bracket. So when you deal with the bracket, you're dealing with something inside. There is a total of two terms inside. But can you plus them? Look at this thing. When the unknown is the same thing, you can continue with a plus minus, but can you plus? No, because they show different unknowns. Stop. That will be the answer. So what you notice is there's a minus 3 here. So you have to tell yourself, there is how many terms inside, you have to multiply how many times. So we have to do one by one. So one time, two time. Okay, so I just cover up the plus 3 here. Okay, can you tell me these k's? Okay, same thing, right? Okay, minus and a plus. Or maybe you can say negative, positive is the same. You get a minus, 3 times 2, you get a 6. A, just put it back because we are dealing with times now. Okay, and then you are done with these 2a, you cover up and you do the second time of your multiplying. Okay, so minus and plus, you get a minus. 3 times 3, you get a 9. So you get the answer now, you see. So moreover, when you check again, can you see that's a plus minus question? You see, minus 6a minus 9, different unknown. Stop, that will be your answer, okay? Now then we further down to another level. Okay, let's say we increase into minus 3a bracket, 2a square minus 5ab, for example. It's the same thing. Bodmas means B-O-D-M-A-S. B means bracket lah. Okay, so bracket, you can't do it. Why? Because plus minus question, unknown related. Okay, same unknown. You plus minus, different, you stop. Different or same? A square, AB, different unknown, you can't minus. If you can't minus, there's a minus 3A. So multiply it. So what is the first set? So cover up this one. By the way, there's two terms, that's why I have to multiply two times. If let's say there is a total of three terms, then you have to multiply three times. Even if, let's say, I get you 100 terms, you have to multiply 100 times. Okay, so I cover up this one. Okay, I do the first set. Okay, so multiplying it. So first set, minus and plus, you get a minus. 3 times 2, you get a 6. A square, you get an A3. Cover up this. Repeat the same steps. Double minus, you get a plus. Okay, now after that, you get a 15 because of number. Then after that, you get A square at B. You get the answer already. Okay? And now, finally comes into the hardest level in your form 2. So you get something like bracket, right? Not? So let's say I get you a 3a minus 2, then you get a, let's say, 4a minus 5. Okay, probably I make it a plus, same thing. So how you deal with this thing, okay? In the next video, I'll be talking about this part, the particular part. So the important thing is, when you talk about how form 1, okay, form 1 algebraic slowly evolve into form 3 level. These are the things. You see, so from form 1, this is still under form 1. It's still under form 1. When you come into form 2, it becomes harder like this. So it's like slowly, progressively. This one is like roughly form 2 already. Okay? So, of course, this last question over here, the more advanced level it happens in your form 2, of course. So I'll be showing you the normal way as well as the so-called AdMaths way, which is the faster way. Okay, so in the next video, we will talk about that. Okay, so stay tuned. So these are the baby steps I'm going to show it to you. So if you like it, subscribe for the next video.